something different about a big wall and really having to use your climbing skills and then dancing. That's the origin of the idea. It's about pushing yourself to your limit, being hot, being tired, being sore, being hungry, and then still finding a reason to dance.
Dance is 15 minutes to show, 10 minutes to walk.
Be very, very safe tonight, especially. Check your knot, check your partner's knot. Watch for each other.
To me, Project Bandaloop is the manifestation of a vision of possibility.
Dancing with Bandaloop is totally addictive. I think it touches into this universal desire to fly and to be, to defy gravity.
Today we have with us Project Bandaloop presenting Lock, an evening of selected works.
Project Bandaloop began in Yosemite when I first rappelled off some rock and realized how amazing it felt to push off the rock and bounce for a second.
It is Wednesday, mid-morning, late May 2007, rolling towards Yosemite Valley to launch the first step towards rehearsal on the Leaning Tower.
This company, everyone has intense, very strong relationships with each other within the company.
There's so many things that you have to be aware of, listening to the music, listening for cues, looking if it's possible to see other dancers.
Oh my gosh, am I going to be able to do this? Once you get out there on stage, this is what you do.
You know, tensions get high sometimes when people are under stress. Maybe people can be a little snappy.
I'm hearing you and I'm like, oh, it could be nice, but I'm thinking about the 9 hours on that ledge tomorrow. And yes, we'd be rehearsing somewhat, but still, you guys, it's a lot. It is.
Anyone who dances in this company is really accustomed to, they may not like it, but we're all accustomed to the fact that we're constantly having to negotiate the space in order to do the choreography.
Just every muscle is overworking to try to integrate what you're doing and how to land and, you know, kind of center yourself in your harness.
There's a responsibility that you have to take for yourself as well as the people that you're dancing with. Because of the risk factor, because of the challenge of bringing artistry into something that is so physically challenging and demanding, it's not easy.
The dancers have learned to trust my work and my expertise and my vision of what is dangerous. So in our case, we have a 3-check process.
Back of knots in, 2 plates, lock and carabiner, 2 belay loops, locked back.
Back of knot?
Yeah.
Back of knot?
Yeah.
Directionals in place and locked. Good to go.
And they know the rigging is bomber. And they know when they go to clip in, they're going to have a safe performance so they can focus on the art.
His job tends to be the conservative one, to be the nitpicky, detailed, strict side of things.
Nope, sorry.
Just be mindful of the outside ropes with the moving lights. I don't think we're going to come close to them, but I'm not sure how sharp the edge of that pipe is.
Thomas really like cuts it and says, okay, this is the part of the vision that can happen. This part of it. And then so Amelia within that will have a big vision. And Thomas cuts it again and says, this is the part of that that can happen.
You can call me a pain in the ass.
You're a pain in the ass.
She may ask for things that are physically impossible, but we'll try to achieve them.
And I'm allowed to be the dreamer.
And it's my job to help mesh that in and make that a finished product, a production that she's happy with, and then the audience will be happy.
Today is April 4th, opening night. We ran into unbelievable technical difficulties with the city.
They were kind of in a losing battle tonight with the traffic scene, and they've asked us to go use lights, but use them at half power and not change color, not change focus.
The city's concerned about traffic and lights, which is reasonable, but it seems that really it's probably more about some kind of political battle.
If there's any risk that we're going to have the same problem tomorrow night, then I'd rather turn the lights on and then spend the next 2 days with our lawyers trying to fight this out to make the show happen.
That is unbelievable that guy won't fight for it.
There's a lot of unknowns and I just can't worry about it. If the wall goes black but the music keeps playing, keep dancing.
Project Bandaloop is ramping up. We are getting busier. We have more dancers than we've ever had before, and we have more gigs than we've ever had before.
So I'm thinking we just end in a circle.
I love it.